Hi everyone, welcome back to Pharmacology Classes by MSR. So in 4th semester we have experimental pharmacology as an elective. So in that first topic we are going to discuss is different species and strains of animals. In unit 1, the first topic is description and application of various species and strains of animals. So as we all know that pharmacology is a science which deals with the drugs. Whereas experimental pharmacology is the one which is going to deal with the various pharmacological agents which are studied on different animal species. We are going to use the animal species for studying of various drugs. So what we are going to get from this experimental pharmacology? What is the aim of this experimental pharmacology? So we can find out a therapeutic agent which is suitable for the human use. We can study the toxicity of the drugs. We can know the mechanism of action. And site of action of that particular drug can be known by doing the experimental pharmacology, nothing but by doing the experiments on the animals. So we can discover the new drugs or we can find the actions of various already existing drugs. How we are going to do? So any drug to be tested, first before the human use, we are going to test it on the animals. That is preclinical studies. So preclinical studies can be done either in vitro or in vivo. In vitro is nothing but we are going to isolate an organ or tissue and we are going to do the study in the laboratories. Whereas in vivo is we are going to do the experiment or study in the intact animal. Once the preclinical studies are cleared, all the results are good, then we can proceed for the clinical studies, which can be done in phase 0, 1, 2 and 3 and 4, which is the post-marketing surveillance, the last stage. So what is species and strain? What is the difference between species and what are strains? So species are the organisms which can reproduce with one another and they can produce natural offsprings. Okay, fertile offsprings. Whereas a strain is nothing but we are going to take a species and we are going to do some genetic molecular modifications or variations in the genes will be happening so that we have some different subtype of a biological species. So species are natural, where we are doing the manipulations and we are creating the strains. The subtype of species are nothing but strains. So the species will have genetic similarity so that they are sufficient for mating, they can produce a fertile offsprings and all. Whereas strain, they are the isolate of given species with a specific genetic characteristic. We are taking a specific gene so that we are creating the subtype of species so they have some specific character in them. So species can be characterized by genetic, biochemical or phenotypic criteria, whereas strains can be characterized by serotypic, enzyme type, functional traits or protein plasmid characterization, etc. So some of the species used in the biomedical research includes the mice, rat, fish, guinea pig, dogs, birds, non-human primates, etc. All these are the various species which are included in the biomedical research. So what are the different types of strains? Nothing but we are doing some manipulations in the species. The subtype of species are nothing but strains. So we are isolating some 10 genes, nothing but isogenic strains, mutations, and we are creating mutant strains. We are transferring the genes and creating transgenic strains. We are taking out some gene and creating knockout strains, outbreed strains. All these are the different types of strains that can be used in the research. So the commonly used laboratory animals, all of them come under the kingdom of Animalia, phylum of Crodanta, class of mammalian. Some of the examples are like monkey, pig, rat, mouse, chimpanzees, cat, dogs. So these are some of the most commonly used experimental animals. Apart from that, we can use birds, reptiles, amphibians, fish. So all of them belong to the class of mammalian. So let's see some of the most commonly used species. The first one are rat. It comes under the species of Rattus nergivus. The most commonly used rat is Wister rat. So apart from this Wister rat, we have Sprague Dawley rats, biobreeding rats, long Evan rats, Jucker rat, hairless rats, etc. All these are different types of rats which are available for the research. Let's see some differences between the rats. So, Wister rats are resistant to infections. The low have low incidence to tumors. They have wide head, long ears, and the tail length is less when compared to the body length. Whereas Prague Dolly rats, they have a longer tail. They have a longer and narrow head. They are very rapidly growing, and they have less. They are more less prone to the respiratory infections. So apart from that, long Evans rat, Sprague Dolly rats, spontaneous hypertensive rats. These are the other rats. So I have explained about them. So the biological, physiological, and specific features of rats. They typically weigh around 250 grams. The lifespan will be 2 to 3 years. The gestational period is 21 to 23 days. And the litter size, nothing but at a time, how many babies they can deliver. So 8 to 10 babies can they can give birth to 8 to 10 babies. And the Easter cycle is around 4 to 5 days. The physiological data, heart rate will be 300 to 500 beats per minute. Respiratory cycle is 65 to 180 cycles per minute. Tidal volume is 1.5 ml. And in a day, they can take around 10 to 20 grams. Coming to the specific features, they don't have a vomiting centers, they don't have tonsils, they don't have gallbladder. They have diffused pancreas and coprography, nothing but they eat the fecus of itself. And the tail of the rat can be used for thermoregulation. So the blood can be collected from the rats through the saphenous vein, dorsal pedal vein, without requiring the anesthesia. With anesthesia, they can take the blood samples from the tail vein, orbital sinus, jugular vein, and blood vessel cannulation. Experimental uses with rats. They can be used to study the analgesics, anticonvulsant activity, to study the estrus cycle, mating behavior, lactation, to know the gastric acid secretion, to study the hepatotoxicity studies, to study the mast cells, and to do various bioassays like insulin, oxytocin, vasopressin, we can use the rats. Moving on to the next species of animals, mice, which is Mus musculus, which is the smallest animal and easy to handle. It is very easy to maintain the mice. And the dose required for these mice is very small. It has different species like Swiss albino mice, etc. Biological data and physiological data of mice. It weighs around 20 to 40 grams. Lifespan will be around 1.5 to 2.5 years. Gestational period is 19 to 21 days. Litter size is 5 to 7. Easter cycle is also for 4 to 5 days. Whereas the heart rate, it is 330 to 780 beats per minute. Respiratory cycle is 84 to 230 cycles per minute. Tidal volume is 0.1 to 0.23 ml. And the daily intake of food will be around only 4 to 5 grams. So one of the strain of this mice is nude mouse, which is also called as hairless genetic mutant mouse. So the thymus is absent. The T lymphocyte tissue immunity, which is helping for the immunity and transplantation research. When coming to the blood collection from mice, it can be done through the tail vein, tail snape, orbital sinus and jugular vein with anesthesia. Without anesthesia, blood can be collected from saphenous vein, dorsal pedal vein, etc. Coming to the experimental uses of mice, it can be used for the toxicological studies, to study the teratogenicity activity, to do the biological assays of insulin, screening of analgesic, anticonvulsant activity like rats, screening of various therapeutic agents, and studies related to genetics and cancer research can also be done on mice. So how to differentiate between the rat and mice? So by seeing the size itself, rats will be larger in size when compared to the mice. And the mice will have the pointed face when compared to rats. Both of them will have a long tail, but the mouse will have a longer tail when compared to the mice. That is nothing but when compared to the body, it will have a longer tail. And the pair of chromosomes will be more for the rats. And the gestational period for the rats will be more when compared to the mice. So these are the prominent features, differentiation between the rat and mice. So in the image, you can see some more differences. So next species of animals are rabbits, which are very easy to maintain, nothing but a docile animal. The most common used strain is New Zealand white strain of rabbit. It will be large, broad, and a muscular body is present. So here are the biological specific features and physiological data about the rabbits. Like there will be around 1.5 to 5 kgs, lifespan is 4 to 6 years, gestation is 31 days, litter size is 6 to 8. Coming to the special features, it have a huge cecum, long appendix, the ovulation is non-spontaneous and it contains the enzyme called as atropine esterase and it is highly sensitive to histamine. Physiological data, it will take around 150 to 300 grams of food, heart rate is 130 to 300, respiratory rate is 38 to 60 minutes per minute, tidal volume is 19 to 24 ml. Blood volume is 4 to 8, that is nothing but percentage of body weight, 4 to 8% of the body weight. Blood collection can be done from rabbit through the marginal ear vein, which is the most preferred site. Apart from that, we can use the jugular vein, orbital sinus or cardiac puncture by anesthetizing the animal. Moving on to the experimental uses, it can be used for pyrogen testing, for doing the bioassay of anti-diabetic drugs, or we can check the sex hormones, screening of various activities like capillary permeability, to check the glaucoma drugs, to check the pharmacokinetic studies, and it is most preferred or the choice of drug animal for doing the cardiac studies, for doing the teratogenic studies, for reproductive studies, meiotic and midriatic, for sympathetic and parasympathetic drugs. And it can also be used for DRACE test, nothing but to check the cosmetics and other chemicals, how they are showing, whether they are irritating, where they are creating redness or damage for the skin. That can also be tested on the rabbits. The next species of animals are guinea pigs, which have a scientific name of Cavia porcellus. They are very easy to maintain, so they are docile animals. They are susceptible to for TB and anaphylaxis. They have sensitivity for the histamine and penicillin. They require the exogenous supplement of vitamin C in their diet. Moving on to the biological, physiological and blood collection data of guinea pigs. They typically weigh around 800 grams. Lifespan will be around 3 to 5 years. Gestation period is 68 days and the litter size will be 3 to 4. They can give birth to the babies, like 3 to 4 babies can be born at a time. Moving on to the physiological data. They will take 40 to 50 grams of food per day. Heart rate will be 260 to 400 beats per minute. Respiratory cycles will be 70 to 104 per minute. And the blood volume, that is 6 to 12% of the body weight. So how the blood sample collection can be done? It can be taken through the marginal ear vein or through cardiac puncture or through the metatarsal veins. The blood sample can be collected. Moving on to the experimental uses with guinea pig, it can be used to evaluate the bronchodilatory action for local anesthetics and for anaphylactic reactions, immunological studies. As I told, it is sensitive for histamine. We can do the studies for histamine, antihistamine drugs, for the evaluation of local anesthetic activity, to do the bioassay of digitalis, and we can take the isolated tissues of guinea pig ileum, heart, and we can check the test drugs of TB, we can check the ascorbic acid metabolism, and the hearing experiments can also be done by using the guinea pigs.